This entire website is programmed by AI. It uses the JavaScript library HTMX to dynamically create AI-generated web designs. All you need to do is describe the UI that you want to see on the HTML element. And if you're not happy with the result, you can just let AI write an entirely new version. Keep clicking until you're happy with the result. For those of you who know HTMX, this will look slightly disturbing. And for those of you who don't, HTMX is the JavaScript framework to end all frameworks, and it's also the frontend library of peace. But whether it's a framework or a library, HTMX does not work like most modern frontend frameworks. Most modern web applications fetch JSON data from a backend server. The client then uses the structured data to render the HTML. But HTMX uses a completely different approach, called HTML over the wire. Instead of JSON data, the server sends rendered HTML to the client, and the client uses it to update the website with it. So, what do we need to make the tedious process of web design a thing of the past, and make AI-generated content work in HTMX? First, HTMX has to send a request to the server with the information about the UI that we want the AI to create. Then, the server will do some fancy AI magic based on that prompt, and once it's done, it will finally send back the HTML to the client, where it is inserted into the DOM. First things first, how do we send a request to the server? Thankfully, sending requests in HTMX is quite straightforward. Just put an attribute like hxget or hxpost on an element. This will make sure that every time someone clicks on that element, it will send a request to the provided URL. And sure enough, you can also include data within the request. But you don't have to worry about any of that. The HTMX-AI extension provides some very nice syntactic sugar around the HTMX API. By using the HX-AI attribute, you can describe the web design that you want to generate directly on the element. After the button is clicked, HTMX will send the prompt to our magic AI backend server. HTMX will also handle the response of the server. But before we look at that, let's finally see where the magic happens. So, what is going on inside of that magic AI backend server? Some revolutionary new technology? Did we finally discover AGI? Not quite. It is a well-known industry secret that AI applications these days are one of two things. Either just a bunch of if statements or a ChatGPT wrapper. ChatGPT was the best large language model that I could find for the job, but there's one big problem. ChatGPT is really expensive. Thankfully, Microsoft does not only love OpenAI, but they also love us.
Developers, 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 developers. Yes!
And they give you $2,500 in OpenAI credits when you join their Startup Founders Hub. So HTMX-AI is officially a startup now. And don't worry, I will make sure that in traditional startup manner, you can help me burn all of that Microsoft money. But before we do that, we have to address something else. ChatGPT is yapping a lot. So I had to do something about that. Otherwise, all of those sweet ChatGPT credits that I was just granted will be gone in no time. And I want to make sure that you can burn my ChatGPT credits in the most efficient way possible. It was surprisingly difficult to get ChatGPT to only respond with the HTML code, but adding rules to the user and system prompts and telling it what a creative genius it is helped to please the AI overlords and get what we wanted. We finally have just the AI-generated HTML code based on our prompt, but does it actually look any good? We'll find out once we see it rendered on the client. So let's send the HTML code back to the client so we can use it with HTMX. With HTMX, we can use hxtarget to decide where the HTML from the backend server should be inserted. The target element can be configured with a CSS selector, and after HTMX receives the response, it will render the AI-generated HTML code into the target element. And here it is, the first HTMX AI-generated red shiny button. But we can go further than that, much further. What would be an AI web design extension without a website built by AI? Let's use HTMX-AI to generate a hero section and add a button so we can just regenerate the section until the AI produces something that is actually usable. Using the newer ChatGPT 4 model resulted in a massive improvement over ChatGPT 3.5. It followed instructions better and generated nicer looking designs overall. After repeating the steps, generating designs for a feature section and a footer was pretty straightforward. The overall website looks, well, pretty generic to be honest, but it shows that you can actually use HTMX-AI for quick wireframing and prototyping, which is also the only use case I'd recommend it for. I really hope I do not have to clarify this, but do not ever use untested and unreviewed AI-generated code in production applications. Artificial intelligence is a tool to help and assist you with your work. But there's no guarantee that the next ChatGPT response won't include some trash code that will break your entire applications and make it go up in flames. That being said, let's go back to our original red button and let's see how much AI can improve itself. By feeding the original source code back into the AI, we can make our simple red button infinitely better. So let's see what our self-improving AI system ends up with. Amazing! So that's what the ultimate button looks like according to ChatGPT. Thank you, AI overlords. All the demos shown in this video are available at htmx-ai.bufferhead.com for you to play around with. It will keep working until you've used up all of that $2,500 that Microsoft granted me for this project. But before you go there to burn up all of that Microsoft money, please make sure to leave a like on this video if you enjoyed it and subscribe if you want to see more content like this. The source code for HTMX-AI can be found on GitHub, so you can prototype your own HTMX applications using AI. See you in the next video.